Michelle, welcome to the program.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Kumusta?
Good to be back.
I know. After what?
Two and a half.
One decade.
Yeah. 2 years.
Kasi nung huli kang nandito, you were what? Newlywed.
Yes.
If I remember correctly. And now you're a new mother.
Yeah, I am.
Bilis ng panahon din.
I know.
But you look very good.
Thank you. I didn't actually have time to fix my hair, so it's kind of wet. Your AD was like, pwede ka na mag-change. I'm like, this is what I'm wearing.
Yeah.
She was like, ay, so nice. Huling-huli.
Love it. Tapos sabi ni Camille, like, one of her writers, that's what I'm going to wear
that
tomorrow.
That was her. She's like, I'm going to wear it tomorrow. I'm like, okay.
That's what I'm going to wear tomorrow. She's kanina, alam mo yung that question, if I were to invite people to a summer vacation, I'd really, you know, invite people like Sharon, your mom. And we were talking about your mom. Yun, yung dalawang bagay, hindi ko malilimutan yun. Una, yung beauty is about youth. Pangalawa, when she won as Miss Universe, and then when she gave her crown to the next winner, sabi niya, kakalimutan ka, na hindi mo nga alam kung paano ka uuwi at babalik sa hotel. Yeah. Which means, we were saying that, you know.
Everyone is basically replaceable. She always tells me that.
Yeah.
It's ingrained in my head.
Totoo. That the one immutable law also in the celebrity business is that nothing lasts forever.
That's something that is learned the hard way.
Tama.
And growing up, when I would complain about work, she says, don't make quitting showbiz a problem.
There was a time in this country when people were expecting you to join beauty contests.
Yes.
What was your conversation like with your mom about it?
I think it was something that we laughed about. We both understood that that's not where I wanted to be.
That was not a path you wanted.
Yes, yeah. And I think if you know me as a person, you'll understand why.
But you were aware that there was that national conversation.
I think I was a little bit aware of it. I didn't realize that there were people who were kind of really hoping that, and it was very
sweet. There were a lot.
Yeah, that was really
passionately hoping.
Sweet, yeah.
You know,
but there's no need. Look how many crowns we have now.
I know, diba? Galeng. But you know, your mom has always been very present with Marge. It's fascinating because nanalo si Pia, nanalo si Kat, pero present. Andun lagi ang your mom will always be the first Miss Universe who won the yeah. title. I mean, that's not gonna change. Kagabi lang, I was watching. I don't know if you've seen that, guys. Yung nakaupo silang dalawa, the previous winners.
Okay.
And then she takes a walk.
Yeah.
You know, on I don't know if it's on Facebook or YouTube.
Okay.
I always chance upon it.
Upon that?
Yeah.
No, I didn't watch that.
And she glides. She doesn't walk. In fairness to your mom.
I don't watch my mom's videos when I sleep.
Hindi, pero gliding ang glory. And there's another thing about your mom. Hindi yan naniniwala na ako'y taga Borongan, Eastern Samar, at ako'y galing sa isang napakahirap na pamilya. I don't know if she remembers this. Parati niyang sinasabi sa akin, naniniwala naman ako sa'yo. Galing-galing mo mag-Ingles. Glory, naaaral yan. At natatapilog pa rin ang dila ko paminsan-minsan. That was just very funny. But that's the kind of person I'd like to spend days with. You know, doing conversations.
You know, be careful what you wish for.
Talaga. No, but remember, I spent a lot of time with your mom when you were judging SCQ, so...
Yes, that was,
know?
Oh my gosh,
and
that
Ava was
a decade ago.
Yeah, 2005, more.
Yeah. My gosh.
Diba? So we spent a lot of time together. So kanina sabi nga natin, the last time you were here, you were newlywed, now you're a mother. Motherhood, let's talk about pagiging nanay.
Yes.
Paano nabago ang point of view mo? With motherhood.
Aww.
Oh, there he is.
I think there's a lot of aspects, and I always say this when people ask me what's changed. I try to explain it as best as I can. I say I've never been more of myself than as a mother, and it's kind of like coming into your own for me.
Anong ibig sabihin?
It's like, you know, when you're in your teens, you're kind of still discovering the world, right? And you're discovering who am I? And then when you're in your 20s, you're like, is this me? Like, is this what I like? Do I like to go out to parties? Do I like to hang out with these types of friends? And then when I get to my 30s and I have a child, I'm more self-aware of what I like. I can say no to things that I don't want to do. And I choose the people who I have conversations with.
Mm-hmm.
You kind of filter out what you've been through and the experiences. And as a mother, now I know that, okay, this is what I want to be. I want to be a mother who has time for her child.
That's right.
Yeah.
And you know, and the journey continues. Ganda.
Definitely. Another thing I learned is probably the balance of life. When I was younger, I wanted to work. I was so afraid that I would lose work. Like as if that was the only thing I was living for. And now that I have a child, it's like work is not the only thing that makes me happy. It's a balance of it. So there's really finding your purpose. What is your mission? Like, what is your mission? Like, do you know what your what is your purpose in life or your mission?
You're asking me. My purpose has always been to provide the best I can for my mother.
Okay.
It had always been that. She's the center of my life. Let's not talk about God here, because first, I'm a child of God. But second, I will always be anak ng aking ina.
Yes.
Everything else is a footnote.
Yeah.
So, pero merong, I have periphery. I don't believe kasi in just being one.
Yeah.
I believe in being many.
Okay.
So, I want to be a teacher. I want to be a host. I want to be a friend. I want to be a partner.
Yeah.
But my purpose basically is... No, not basically. My purpose is really to provide the best I can for my mother.
And so the decisions you take in life, you think...
That's my compass.
Yeah, so that's your compass. Like, is this going to lead me to where I'm supposed to be? Right?
No, and that's the reason why, importante mga kaibigan, para sa akin ha, ang pangarap, ang dreams, the reason why we're able to say no and yes to certain things is because you go back to that compass. Itong gagawin kong bagay ba na ito will support my mission, my purpose.
Exactly.
Ito ba maglalayo sa akin doon? Like for example, I was offered jobs that would take me away from my home where my mother stays.
Yeah.
So halimbawa, labing araw, wala ako sa bahay for X number of months, sabi ko ayoko.
Yes, exactly. So that's something I learned also as a mother. I redefined what makes me successful. Growing up, you know, success is hammered to us as having, owning a home, having
cars,
money. Beautiful money, owning the nicest bags, right? And then in the end, you see there are so many people who have this but don't feel that type of happiness or, you know. So how did I redefine my success? And my husband also helped me with this. It's really about balancing your life and what and aligning with your purpose.
Tama. And it doesn't come easy. When you talk about balance, it doesn't happen tomorrow. You know, it's a journey to get there.
It's a journey. It's you create your future every single day.
Tama. And you mentioned your husband because now it's a different life. You have a partner. You have a baby. So iba ang dynamics, di ba?
Yes, definitely. When you get married, everything changes. And then when you have a child, you're totally responsible for this other human being.
Right.
And people have this notion that you have to be a hands-on mom. You have to do everything. And it's difficult.
Are you hands-on with Balti?
I am, yes. But I also like to give him his own space to grow with other people. Because I don't think that he can only learn from me.
Uh-oh. And while creating that balance, along the way, hindi lahat tama.
Yeah.
Magkakamali ka, matututo ka, may mga leksyon kang matututunan, and then you do conversations with your partner, what things are we doing right and what are we doing wrong?
Exactly.
Diba?
Yeah.
So that's part of, I mean, it's really exciting. Kanina, let's just go back to the purpose. Ako ang nadiskubre ko rin, iba ang expression and articulation of the purpose. Pagbata ka, iba ang sinasabi mo.
Yeah, you're
still discovering. But when you go back to your core, you will discover that what you are has always been who you are.
Yes, it's true. And I believe in that children will tell you what they like to do at an early age. You as a parent just have to listen.
Tama. Okay.
And I can go on and on about it.
You are not a fan of people saying that, ang gwapo-gwapo ng anak mo, etc. Somebody told
yes,
you this.
Yes, that is correct. You know, I just feel like in the Philippines, and when you're in show business, plus social media, a lot of people focus on your physical attributes. And I'm somebody who's grown up with a family who's part of that, right? Of course, my mom, that pressure. So it was instilled in me that it's very, very, very important. And sometimes that can kind of define who you are. So I don't want his looks to define who he is.
And did you rebel against that? Because you're a member of a gorgeous, beautiful family, di ba?
I mean,
nagrebelde ka.
I don't think rebelde is the right word. I think what I would say is I was sucked into it, and
okay.
But I see the benefits of it, and I'm not going to deny that obviously it's very nice to be told these things, but it's not the real world.
But the pressure that went with it.
The pressure
not just
is
your mom, huh? The sisters of your titas.
Definitely, yes. There was definitely pressure that comes with that, and the name you hold. So there's a lot of things that create your identity before you even know your identity, right? So with my son, parang I don't want him to think that that's the only thing that matters.
It's good.
And even when people know his name, laging sinasabi, can you ask him his name? Because I don't want him to go into the world thinking everyone knows me. It's hard to be born with fame because
it is
you think you're
very hard.
You think you're entitled.
You are entitled.
And you go around the world and you see the real world and you're like you're kind of lost or. And I experienced that also because people were so much kinder to me here and I absolutely loved it. Of course, if you tell my mom, she'll be like, are you kidding me? Try to get, you know, additional luggage if you don't look like you. I'm like, okay.
It's so your mom.
I know, it's so her. But I think there's pros and cons.
Of course.
Yeah.
There are things that you can't deny. I mean, you have to be grateful for certain things. But I know where you're coming from. And it also begins with simple things like, oh nga, huwag naman masyadong, ang guwapo-guwapo mo, blah, blah. There are other things. Outside of being guapo, about being good looking. And remember, your son eventually will be his own.
Yeah.
He'll be his own person and will be on his own.
Exactly. So, and I just don't want to put so much weight on his looks as if that was equivalent to who he is as a person.
You call your son.
I call him Balti or Balthazar.
Balti.
Yeah.
But you add sometimes the name of your
Balti Boo, Balti Bong is my dad's.
To pay tribute to Bong.
Yeah, it's just like a nickname.
That's true.
Yeah.
He was a gorgeous man.
Thank you.
No, he was. He was a gorgeous and kind man.
Thank you.
He was a friend. Okay. May napanood din ako sa YouTube yung mm-hmm. your journey of losing 68 pounds. How important was that?
I think I made that my job for the past 6 months because I had gained a tremendous amount of weight. Almost 3 times the
expected. With pregnancy?
With pregnancy, yes.
Okay.
You know, sometimes when I look back, I also think, how did I gain that much weight when I was trying to be careful? But it happens.
It does.
I'm human.
Okay.
Yeah.
Pero along the way, hindi mo ba inisip, Belle, that you could also have sent, you know, that message? You know how it is today in social media?
Yes.
The body shaming thing?
Of course, yeah, definitely.
And then creating the stereotypes?
Yes. Yeah, no, I'm well aware of that. And I, you know, when I created, the reason why I created this is because a lot of people were asking me how I lost weight.
Okay.
And social media has this deceiving side to it where, you know, everyone thinks it's all perfect. And they think that there's not a lot of work that goes into that, right?
That everything is easy.
Yes, everything is easy. And more than weight, it's also your health, my health. Because I was, at the end part, was diagnosed with gestational diabetes. But I'm not going to sugarcoat it. It's definitely weight. It was my insecurity. It's something that I had a problem and it was my truth. I can't lie about it.
Pero bata ka pa lang, di ba? Meron ka nang ganun.
I was always skinny, but I definitely had insecurities about my body. Like any, I would think, normal girl,
young girl.
Teenage
yes.
girl. So with my video, I don't mean to body shame people, and I just, if that's how they took it, then that was not the intention.
No, but that was not your story. That's what you're trying to say.
Yeah, that was not my story, and I struggled with I struggled with body shaming myself.
Right.
And I struggled to love myself, and I had to see a therapist for that. And that's a whole different, like, content, because she told me, you have to know that you're enough for your son to know that he's enough.
Again, that's good. You have to know
that you are enough.
That you are enough for your son to know
that he is enough.
Makes a lot of sense.
So when she told me that, I said, you're right. Mm-mm. You know, I'm not going to do this for anyone but for myself.
That's true.
And people talk about body love, but it's very difficult to get there. You know, I had to look in the mirror every single day and tell myself I am enough. It was mental fitness that I was also practicing.
Aside from the physical fitness.
Yeah, so
they have to go together.
Because like physical fitness, you have to work out every day to be fit. Like mental, you have to train the brain to think that way.
To also to be fit.
So to be fit, you have to affirm yourself. And that's really my turning point in my story.
Galing. Okay. I mean, Belle, doon sa YouTube, doon sa your journey, doon sa 68 pounds na nawala sa iyong katawan, is there a basic move that you do that you actually shared with your audience?
Yes. No. Do you want to do it?
Yeah, I want to do it.
Okay, so we did a lot of squats. And what's this good for? Jumping squats. I should have worn my athlete shirt, yeah. But anyways. So you just go down like this and you jump up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, so sometimes I would do like 100 of that. And
100 of that?
Yeah. but you know, you can make it like throughout the day if you want.
Yeah, I will not lie, but you know, masakit sa tuhod.
To get you to move more.
Ganda. No, but what you're trying to say is you don't have to do the 100 in one go.
Go.
I mean, you can do it. I mean, you can do 20, you can do 30.
Yeah, exactly. 20 after, go to the bathroom. I mean, it's really just to get your body.
Yeah, and not only that, it's being practical because hindi naman tayo lahat talaga pwedeng
mag-ganon. Oh, yeah, exactly.
Nang isang daan, di ba? Belle, you've never been famous for being shy about your opinions. You've been very, very, very straightforward. You would get into trouble sometimes with the opinions that you would share with your followers, with the public. Meron ka bang isang opinion na naibahagi mo sa publiko na pinagsisihan mo ang kasagutan sa pagbabalik po ng TWBA? Kami nagbabalik po dito sa TWBA. Kasama pa rin po natin si Belle Daza. Very interesting. I caught this and I wanted to talk about this. Kontrata sa mga kasambahay. Congratulations.
Yes. Thank you.
You know, really.
Thank you.
Congrats. Ang ganda. Paano nag-umpisa ito? Paano mo ito naisip?
Okay, so I'm not going to take the credit for this. My husband told me that
galing.
I need to have a contract with the maids because it protects both parties. Tapos inexplain niya na you have to write down their list of deliverables para if something happens, you can't get mad at them for forgetting your charger when that's not their job. Alam mo yon. So there, it came from there, and then I said it also gives them dignity, I think, to have a
piece of paper. There's a
piece of paper, yeah. And I think, of course, people are always scared to lose their jobs, right? So I had to explain also to my helpers that, listen, I can't fire you just because I'm in a bad mood or I'm hungry.
Right.
These are the rules. Shemper, you can't steal from me and things like that. So I wanted them to have something that will make them feel they can sleep better and will also appreciate them, and so they also know their KPI and deliverables.
Tama, kasi ang kontrata naman ay agreement ng dalawang tao po. Dalawang tao, hindi lamang karapatan ng isa, karapatan ng dalawa.
Exactly.
At kung ano ang partnership na ito. So, makakatulog sila, alam nilang protektado sila dahil alam nila ang sweldo nila, alam nila ang day off nila. I read your contract and it's really interesting. Like, meron silang, hindi lamang day off, pero meron silang bakasyon.
Yes.
Diba?
At the end of the... because I think that, you know, you have to treat people fair. And if you want them to be efficient and you want them to learn, then, I mean, tayo nga napapagod ng 5 days a week. Why do we expect them to be in our house 7 days? Diba? They also need a life. So... I like to give them their own free time.
I want to know, kumusta yung reaction nila the first time you brought up the idea of a contract?
I think they were very touched. Parang napangiti sila because they didn't feel that they deserved one.
Mm.
Yeah, so when you make them feel like, bakit? This is, you know, you're working and you're worth having a contract.
Because ako, I want to do this. I don't have this, I will admit. But the first time I saw... you know, your contract. Sabi ko, ang ganda naman. Pero ako, I talk about this on this show. I encourage my mga kasamahan ko sa bahay na magtipid. So, we talk about this as a discipline, ha?
Yes.
Hindi lang yung magtipid ka, hindi.
No.
Meron kaming targets araw-araw,
yes.
Isang linggo, isang buwan. Dahil, I don't know, pero katulad mo, bawal sa amin ang utang.
Yeah, oh yeah, definitely.
Ayoko yung nangungutang at nag-a-advance.
Oh,
because,
that's my number
sabi
one.
Ko sa kanila, ibig sabihin nun, hindi kayo properly remunerated?
Yes.
Oo. Bawal.
Definitely, yung bawal mangutang. And then I also help them save. Mm-mm. So I give them some people, they don't have bank accounts. So like when I had my first helper come in, both of them didn't have bank accounts. So I gave them a bank account. I said, okay, pag December na, titignan ko kung magkano na naipon mo and dodoblehin ko. And I think that gets them to have a target also. And that makes them feel that this isn't finite. You know, this amount every month. Pwede rin akong kumita pa. So I give them different ideas because I want to help them reach their own goals. Before this, I gave them a questionnaire and I asked them kailan sila nalulungkot, kailan sila masaya, so that I also know them a little bit more.
It's not just about money. It's
not about money. It's EQ. It's the work environment.
About being human.
It's really treating people
fairly.
And having humanity. Yeah. So I am, it's okay.
Thank you. Thank you, Belle, for inspiring us. Sana'y maraming legislators. I'm not familiar with how far the law has gone in the context of, you know, protecting the rights of domestic helpers, for example. Pero napakagandang pag-aralan because it's doable. Why do we have to go abroad to have contracts?
Yeah.
When in fact we can take care of them here.
Exactly, yes.
Diba?
And don't we all have help one way or another?
Totoo. At saka, ang gusto ko, Belle, yung application mo, tayo nga napapagod tayo sa limang, it's you know?
Yeah.
Tayo nga napapagod ng limang araw. So, when you look at your house help, yun yung point of view mo na parang, ito rin, what makes them happy? What makes them cry?
What makes them sad? What food do they like? I think
right.
That's even important. To feel celebrated. One of my drivers told me that when we sang happy birthday to him, never pa daw siyang nakatanggap ng happy birthday cake and for people to sing to him.
No.
And, you know, it's things like that you don't realize that should be normal.
That should be normal.
Yeah.
Ganda. No, I'm really learning. Dahil, ibang kwento because you're a lot younger than us. Pero ako naman, halimbawa, pag pinag-uusapan ng driver, si Sammy, ang pinagmamalaki niya, he has 5 kids, boys. Parati niya sinasabi sa mga driver ng aming kapitbahay, ako limang aking anak na lalaki, lahat sila graduate.
Dibongga. That's pride.
I must have done something right.
Exactly.
Pero can you imagine if I had your contract from the very beginning? Kasi meron pang isang problema. Hindi naman problema, but this is a challenge. When people know that you work for Belle Daza or you work for Gloria Diaz, they think na, ay, pwede ka nang utangan. Ikaw muna mag-advance, magbayad ng ganito, etc. This will also help manage, you know, na, huwi, nagtatrabaho kami.
Yes.
Ito ang aming sweldo.
Yes.
Hindi kami dito namimitas ng, lalo na pag halimbawa, ang pamilya at ang mga kamag-anak ay nasa probinsya.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic idea, really.
Thank
dapat
you.
Gayahin namin lahat yan.
Thank you so much.
Okay, let's go to, you know, this, this is a propensity. You know, this is something natural for you. You have an opinion.
Yes.
Yeah, I have an opinion. And sabi mo nga, sometimes you get into trouble because of your opinions. Meron ka bang opinion na nailabas sa publiko na pinagsisihan?
Definitely. Marami. Marami rin. I think, thank you for rehashing that. Here I am trying to clean my...
Yeah.
No. You know what? It's out there. I think that experience is the name so many give their mistakes. What I learned from this is that humility is learned the hard way.
Yes.
You cannot teach humility when somebody's on the top. Or, I'm not saying that I'm on the top, but when somebody is, let's say, flying high or feels untouchable, you cannot tell him to be humble. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So, humility is learned the hard way, and I learned it the hard way.
Takes a lot of courage.
Yeah, I mean...
Takes a lot of courage to be humble.
It takes so much courage to be humble, and it's so painful to be humble, to learn it.
Do you have a specific opinion? Na pag binabalikan mo, you know, you say, what?
I think there are definitely. I'm not gonna say I don't have any regrets. That's a lie. I have.
Ako din.
Yeah.
That's a lie to say wala kang.
I have regrets. I'm human. I make mistakes. I think that social media magnifies it and a lot of people are easily offended. I'm not going to villainize social media because it helps us a lot. But I definitely think that things can be taken out of context and kind of blown out of proportion when that's not the intention I have.
Right.
But I'm not going to defend myself, like, because I also learned that it just piles on, right? It's funny, I was having a conversation with my high school friends, and my question to them was, what did you learn in your 20s that you would tell in your 30s now that you would tell your 20-year-old self? And each of us, you know, gave an answer.
And what did you say?
That you can't please everybody.
Yeah.
Because we spend our 20s trying to get everyone to like us. And yeah, even I was talking to Raymond Gutierrez about this. And then in the end, you're like, I don't need everyone to like me. I just need to like myself. And that was a very, very important lesson for me. But yeah. you can't learn it when you're young. You have to go through with it. So those mistakes or experiences that really shaped my self-awareness, my empathy, my balance of how I articulate myself.
The whole of who you are.
Everything of who I am. Yeah.
Diba? And you Playhouse.
Yes. Let's slip that in there.
You Playhouse.
1 minute left. Let's talk about Playhouse.
No, but I love it. You're reunited with Zanjo in Playhouse.
Yes, he's my on-screen lover.
Yes.
He and I, because I think he's like one of the taller guys. Maybe, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, but you have, Belle, I've always believed in you, not just as a person, but as an actor. I've seen your movies, and this is our first time I'm saying, there are things you don't learn also as an actor. There are things you don't learn. Okay. There are things that just happen on screen. Mm-hmm. And I think that's why we are in this business, because magic happens. Magic, and you have that. When you're on screen.
Really? Thank you. That's kind.
You know, when you did that role of
Clara.
Yeah.
In Tubing at Langis.
Yeah. Diba? I mean, may mga, how is it working with Angelica Panganiban?
It's very good. I think that she's really funny and very game to do. And she's nakikisama and she makes me feel welcome, which I was a bit scared at first to enter that set. You know, it wasn't my territory, but she is very
But it's
welcoming.
Nice to be scared once in a while.
It definitely, I you know diba? What, now I sit in that fear and I'm like, how do I handle this?
Ganda.
Yeah.
And it can fuel a lot of things.
It fuels it, you to be better.
Fuels excellence.
Alam mo, when you're tested with someone who's very good, you're like, okay, I'm going to do my
best. You have no other way.
Yeah.
But to go there.
Exactly. Exactly.
And Playhouse is extended, mga kaibigan.
Oo nga.
Thank everybody and invite everybody to be part of it.
Maraming salamat po sa lahat na nanonood ng Playhouse. Ako po si Leia, ang girlfriend ni Marlon. But we're seeing some twists now come in. It's every day bago po mag-showtime.
That's right. So watch Belle and everybody in Playhouse. Now we're going to play something different. We're doing this for the first time. Our new 5 in 45. I have photos here. I don't know what they are. Honest. Hindi ko alam. Mga photos ng mga kaibigan mo, describe them, susubukan kong hulaan in 45 seconds. I'm not supposed to be watching the monitor, so I'm gonna be
okay,
here.
Okay,
okay. Tama ba ito? Pag sinabi ko, ganon?
Okay, ready?
Okay. Your time begins now.
Okay, horsey.
Vice. Okay, vice.
Shoppy, pee. It's...
Who's this? Again.
It's showtime. How can you not
make
my best?
Curtis, of course. Yes.
French, wifezilla.
French.
French Filipina wifezilla artist.
Sulen.
Okay. Actress, newly married. I set them up. Beautiful Pinay Ben Cab. Newly married in December. Beautiful.
Ay! Isa. Yes.
Chambi.
Who's Chambi?
The last one.
Okay.
Chambi.
Ah, she taught me how to dance this.
Yes.
Who? Alex! Ang hirap pala. Alex Gonzaga. Wait.
That was good.
Yeah, I know, but
sorry, I should have been a better describing.
Wait, how can I forget? Alam mo, you get lost somewhere along the way. Alex, how could have I forgotten you? You introduced Ben and
Iza.
And Iza.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I was their matchmaker.
Sulen, I mean, how dare me?
Anne was hard because I didn't know what
to
say.
I
said her commercial that everybody sings.
Yeah, I know.
Maybe I should have said it's showtime.
Yes, Anne Curtis, yes, yeah. Married to the Frenchie also.
Yeah. Oh. But it was just, it's too obvious, you know?
Yeah, I know, it was too obvious. It was very easy. Okay, Belle, maraming. It was very easy because, you know,
I was going to say Kim Kardashian.
Vice added, right? Yeah. But thanks a lot. I was expecting kasi the, how's Liz? Have you seen?
Yeah, I was just with her. She just sent me cookies. She's venturing
into
new business now.
Exciting.
But anyways, before we go, what I wanted to say was, I think what makes you a great host, and a lot of people don't know this, is that you're a very good listener.
Well,
people,
thank you.
People forget to listen.
Yes, it's important to listen.
Yeah.
We learn by listening. Thank you, Belle.
Yeah.
But you are a great listener. You listen.
You.
I mean, you know when people listen.
You do. You can tell.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's how you make real connections with people.
Yeah. Because we can go on forever and forever and forever because we're building on each other's words.
Exactly.
Diba? Yes. And that's how you do it. Thank you, Belle.
You're welcome. Thank
you
very
much. And all the love. All the love. All the love. maraming salamat. And thank you. The Philippine Women's University will celebrate its 100 years and grand alumni homecoming on February 24 at the Conrad Hotel. Get in touch with the university for more details. And Voice of La Carmela de Boracay, thank you. And Risa Moises of Chess's Joy Bus, Drs. Manny and Pai Kalayan, Doris Almanzor of IMG, Ambilite, Move On Clothing, Mario Thero, sa lahat ng inyong tulong sa amin sa Make Your Nanay Proud Foundation, maraming salamat. Live and love in abundance and always make your nanay proud. Be kind. Abundance. Good night.